How y'all, first thing first, man, how y'all doing? Hope y'all been good. Hope y'all been straight. Hope y'all been good. Hope y'all been great. Today we doing something different today, man. Today we doing something different. We got that man, Joaquin Von Kill, female K.I. We got another Hip Hop Daily video. Excuse me. I don't know why I just wanted to watch one of these, you know what I'm saying? Just write to one of these today. And we picking Chicago. I was looking for a Chicago one. Rest in peace, King Von. Also, somebody sent me a... Y'all wouldn't believe this. Some little white... I ain't racist or nothing, bro. But some little white kid Instagrammed me a picture of this man death. Like, his dead body. Like, I don't know if y'all seen the picture. I'm pretty sure y'all did. It was going on Twitter or something. Like, his actual dead body. Somebody DM me. Man, I swear to God. I wish I could show y'all, but I can't show y'all because I'm going to see it blocked. But I swear to... It's crazy, bro. I don't know what niggas on me. I don't know what... He's a weirdo, bro. He's a weirdo, bro. But we got Hip Hop Daily, man. Let's get straight into it, man.
King Von is one of the most notorious shooters in Chi-Raq history. But even killers have a sweet spot, and before the money and fame, Von had a crush in Chicago who was also one of his deadliest ops, K.I., a female shooter from the STL EBT set of the GDs. Now Chicago police have announced that Von...
I don't think he really had a crush on her. I think he was just trying to nail shorty. For real, dead Nella. He was trying to nail a dead Nella, if you know what I mean. You know what I mean.
Was one of the main suspects in K.I.'s murder. Let's take a closer look at this wild relationship. King Von grew up in the Killer Ward area of Chicago, but later moved to the infamous O Block. His father, Ada Park Silk, was in and out of his life growing up because
just like him, bro. Damn. that's his father.
He was in and out of jail and was eventually killed when the rapper was just 11 years old. At 16, Von went to jail for the first time, and he would continue to be in and out of the system for the next 10 years until he was killed in late 2020. Von was a member of the BDs and repped the O Block set along with rappers like Chief Keef and Lil Durk. O Block gets its name after a respected member of the BDs named Odie Perry was murdered back in 2011. Odie was another casualty in the ongoing war between the BDs and Parkway Gardens and the GDs from around the area of 63rd and St. Lawrence, also known as STL EBT or Tukaville. The person rumored to be responsible for Odie's death was a girl by the name of Jakaira Barnes, aka K.I. K.I. was a teenage girl who worked her way up to being one of the most feared gang members in all of Chicago. Early on, K.I. was just like any other normal girl. But growing up around so much death and violence in the South Side, as she got older, she quickly adapted to her environment. Her father was killed when she was just a year old, and growing up, she was always protective of those around her because of this early loss. When she was a teenager, she started hanging out with some GDs from the neighborhood, one of which was Tuka. For those that don't know, Shondell Gregory, aka Tuka, was a 15-year-old member of the...
Everybody be talking about, damn, this man was 15. He don't even look 15 in this photo. You see everybody be talking about that he smoked on Tuka. Chief and them, obviously y'all know this. Well, obviously we don't, but I know this. This is why I can... See, I can watch this one because I know what's going on. The New York why I be lost, bro.
The Black Disciples, that was also killed in 2011. Just like Odie Perry, after Tuka died, the St. Lawrence area was renamed Tukaville in his memory. K.I. was good friends with Tuka, and his death is part of what pushed her to become a savage. Tuka was killed by members of the BDs in retaliation for the death of Edric Walker, who was allegedly killed by GD members.
Whoa, that boy got the same last name as me, boy.
Members. After he died, Tuka became a common target for rappers from O Block disrespecting their music, including famous artists like Chief Keef and King Von. Mm-hmm. The constant dissing of Tuka intensified the beef between O Block and STL, and that's also part of what started the beef between K.I. and King Von. After Tuka died, K.I. started getting sucked into the streets. According to rumors, on Tuka's birthday, she went out riding around looking for ops with FBG Butter when they ran into Odie Perry and shot him off his bike. Odie was a member of the BD set Wick City, which would later become O Block. At first, no one wanted to believe that it was a teenage girl who took out a high-ranking member of one of the wildest gangs in Chicago.
I wouldn't believe that either. Y'all gotta understand, bro. Imagine if you getting ran down on by a female, bro. That's crazy. Like, I really wonder what function in this girl head to get in that gang. Like, that's crazy, bro. And she was a real, so apparently she was a real shooter. Like, one of them.
But as K.I.'s reputation in the streets grew, they were forced to accept the truth that K.I. was one of the most ruthless killers in the history of Chi-Raq. K.I. didn't just go after ops. She went after anyone who disrespected her, including other females. She also allegedly once shot at the female cousin of a respected member of O Block named T-Roy. The cousin ended up snitching on K.I., but she still beat the case. Plus, K.I. wasn't just putting in work on the streets. She was also known to brag about her activities on social media, tweeting things like, "Shout out OD for being target practice, LOL, #STL. This is where her relationship with King Von would first begin. Even though Von and K.I. were both technically ops, they had a mutual respect that bordered on flirting. In a documentary about K.I.'s life that aired on A&E, Von even later admitted that he had a crush on K.I. back in the day. But just because they respected each other as ops doesn't mean that they were-
I need to see this interview, bro. Let me know what interview. I never saw this interview before. I need to see that. He said on A&E, I think that's what he said. I need to watch that, bro.
Cool. Despite their attraction to each other, they were still bitter rivals, and it was on site if either one of them caught each other lacking. So they always had a strange relationship. They would be taunting and threatening to kill each other one minute, then start flirting the next. For example, Von once tweeted, "Kyra would be sounding sexy on the phone, on David." He also once tweeted at her and said, "Good afternoon, wifey." She responded, "LOL, hashtag funny ass. What up, dude?" So even though they were enemies, it wasn't all smoke between them. But their conversations weren't always romantic. Once when K.I. tweeted something about OD's death, Von reminded her about the incident where he allegedly beat her up on the train. In the tweets, Von seemingly admits to catching K.I. by herself on the train.
He said, "Fuck OD. See, that's why you be getting beat up." She said, "Spin." Then she said, "I would have hit her spit her." Oh, I thought I was beating her, but I was thinking. Leave it in the street.
And beating her up.
Oh yeah, so he did it. He did. After she said leaving her in the streets, that means she ain't supposed to be talking. So he did beat her.
So just because Von had a crush on her, doesn't mean he's gonna let her forget that they were ops and she killed one of his good friends. After that, Von allegedly went to look for K.I. at a local corner store. Some of her friends blocked him from getting to the store, and Von went to Twitter to air out the situation. And as time went on, their relationship got more threatening and less friendly. In 2012, K.I. tweeted, "You was a hashtag goofy like 2 years ago when my twin at FYB Butter beat your ass, but you drilling now, laugh my ass off, little hashtag Davon." This obviously triggered Von, and they got into a Twitter war after that. Around that time, Von also started warring with another one of K.I.'s good friends, FBG Wooski. Wooski was another rapper slash gang member who grew up in O'Block, but later moved to St. Lawrence after he allegedly killed another respected member of the BDs named Reezy.
This all who Dirk be talking about. Smirk, this the only dude I know that still talk about this man's Wooski. I know he into it with Smirk, like for sure, for sure.
Years later, Wooski was accused of killing another member of O'Block named Platoon, who was close to King Von. So Von retaliated by killing a dude named Modell, who was Wooski's cousin. Wooski became one of O'Block's most hated ops, and he and Von would develop a strong hatred for each other. Check out our video on FBG Wooski, the Gravedigger of Chirac, for more info on this beef. After Modell was killed, Von and Wooski got into a heated argument on Twitter, and K.I. ended up getting involved. During his argument, Von admitted to having several bodies and told both Wooski and K.I. that he wasn't the one to play with. But before anything serious could happen, Von would be arrested for the murder of Malcolm Stuckey and would spend the next 2 years locked up fighting the case. Von allegedly killed a man named Malcolm Stuckey at a house party after he was giving him dirty looks. Von left the party and recruited the help of a BD from O'Block named Big Mike, who happened to be Wooski's brother.
Just show y'all that man body. Just tell him how he killed him for just giving him looks. Just show y'all that man body. I don't know why. Fell in love with his music, bro. I ain't really listening to Chicago, man. I was listening more Atlanta music, Philly, all that before King Von, bro. I'm so mad they killed that man, bro. So mad, bro.
He and Von returned to the party and fired at Stuckey, who was hanging out on the front porch with friends. Stuckey would end up passing away, and two other people would be injured in the shooting. After being questioned by police, Big Mike snitched on Von to get a lighter sentence. But at the last minute, he refused to testify in fear of retaliation by the BDs and ended up taking the fall for the whole thing. No other witnesses agreed to come forward and testify, and there wasn't much other evidence to convict Von. So he was allowed to walk, while Big Mike ended up being sentenced to 28 years. But even while Von was locked up, he continued to think about K.I. While he was in jail, his sister tweeted at K.I. and said, "Bro said come see him, he miss you, no bullshit." Proving that even though he was potentially facing life in prison, he still had a crush on his op. But his hatred for Wooski would only grow stronger after his brother almost put him behind bars for life. So when Von got back on the street, he was out for revenge on anyone who double-crossed him. Before going to jail, Von was allegedly involved in another murder of a local drug dealer affiliated with the Jarrell City set named P5. It's rumored that Von, along with other O'Block members such as J Money and T-Roy, ambushed P5 when he was on his way to making a sale and shot him in the face and body over 15 times. K.I. was close to P5, and while Von was locked up, K.I. would allegedly get revenge by killing J Money. Just a few months before J Money was murdered, he and K.I. would get into a heated Twitter battle where they both threatened to kill each other. So even though Von had a bit of a crush on K.I., she had now killed two of his close friends, OD and J Money. On the same day that Von was released from jail, he responded to one of K.I.'s tweets saying, "What's up, ma? You don't miss a n-." But once again, their relationship would quickly go from flirting to beefing, and K.I. would tweet, "How a fit to lose your homie while you behind them bars doing that time?" Von responded by tweeting, and Modell, and rest in piss, Pete Crack, reminding her that the score was even and that they had both taken out two of each other's close homies.
I don't want to laugh, bro, but just Von's just so disrespectful. That's why I'm laughing, bro. No bullshit.
After that, they got into a crazy Twitter fight. So, despite their past feelings, someone had to go. On April 11th, 2014, KI and FBG Butter were on their way to Wooski's house. Around 6:30 p.m., KI dropped her location on Twitter, which Von and others saw. So Von, along with Big A, T-Roy, and Boss Money, left O-Block, where they quickly spotted Butter and KI. This was the perfect opportunity to get revenge for both J Money and OD. So as soon as they saw the two of them, they started letting off shots. FBG Butter got away, but KI was hit several times and later died from her injuries. Although for years, it was rumored in the streets that Von had killed KI, the police never had enough evidence to prove it. But years later, documents from the Chicago PD were released to the public that indicated Von was a major suspect in her death. According to the paperwork, Von provided two different alibis for the day of the murder and agreed to take a polygraph test. But even though the alibis did not confirm Von's exact whereabouts at the exact time of the shooting, and he never actually took a polygraph test after agreeing to, the DA refused to prosecute because of lack of evidence. So, someone leaked the documents to confirm one of the oldest Chicago street rumors, that Von was involved in the death of his main op and crush, K.I. The story
damn,
of-
so somebody told on that man? Somebody told on the man? And it's still to this day, like, I don't know if y'all know, but like, I don't know how long this was ago. After he died, it was like a few months ago, it really got like confirmed that this man had a few more bodies. If he was still alive, he's probably gonna be no bullshit. He's probably gonna try to lock that man up.
K.I. and King.
Like, no bullshit. Especially for the RICO of FGB Duck. That's what I forgot.
King Von could only happen in a city like Chicago. They both clearly had a thing for each other, but their love wasn't enough to squash the bitter hatred between their two gangs. Who knows what could have happened if they put the past behind them and decided to settle down. But in the end, their relationship could never really happen because there was too much blood on both their hands for either one to let it go.
Excuse me for a second, man. I low-key just fucking blanked out during the video. That's why I wasn't just talking. I was just thinking. I forgot, bro. It's early for me, man. It's my all of the day. Bear with me, man. But look, that's it for today, man. Thank y'all for all the support and love. We have 431 subscribers, man. Don't forget. Don't think I ain't, you know what I'm saying? Don't think I ain't noticing, man. I appreciate all y'all for the love and support y'all been showing the kid. I really do mean this shit from the bottom of my heart. Y'all take care of yourself. Y'all have a drink of water. I'll see y'all in the next video, man. Peace out.